Phyllis George, a former Miss America, television personality and ex-wife of Governor John Y. Brown Jr. has died in Lexington after an illness. George, who had been hospitalized at the University of Kentucky Albert B. Chandler Hospital, was 70. She died Thursday from complications from a blood disorder she had developed in her mid-30s but had managed for many years, Brown told the Courier-Journal on Saturday. Phyllis was a great asset to Kentucky, said Brown, who also lives in Lexington and said he had maintained an amicable relationship with his ex-wife. He said he especially valued their 4 years as Kentucky's governor and first lady. We had a great partnership, he said. I think we enjoyed every single day. Brown said the couple's two children, Lincoln Brown, a technology entrepreneur, and Pamela Brown, a news reporter with CNN, had been with George in recent weeks providing care and support. We're sorry to lose her, her former husband said. She's been a big part of our lives. In a statement, her two children praised George for her strength and spirit. For many, Mom was known by her incredible accomplishments, Lincoln and Pamela Brown said. To us, she was the most incredible mother we could ever ask for, and it is all of the defining qualities the public never saw, especially against the winds of adversity, that symbolize how extraordinary she is more than anything else. The beauty so many recognized on the outside was a mere fraction of her internal beauty, only to be outdone by an unwavering spirit that allowed her to persevere against all the odds. Governor Andy Beshear offered his condolences on Twitter on Saturday. I was blessed to know Phyllis and her family. Her connection with Kentucky runs deep, Beshear said in the tweet. Our thoughts and prayers are especially with her children, Lincoln and Pamela. Louisville Mayor Greg Fisher also spoke out about George's passing, calling her a trailblazing sports broadcaster, first lady, advocate for the arts, and mother, in a tweet. George, a Texan, rose to prominence after winning the 1971 Miss America title at age 21 and relocating to New York, where she said her Texas personality helped her land her first television assignments. Top headlines: McGrath stands by ad despite Republican governor's objections named Miss Congeniality in the Miss Texas pageant. George described herself in a 1998 Courier-Journal interview as a small-town Christian girl, very close to my family, who entered the Miss America pageant determined to win. I was focused, she said. I was prepared. In New York, after appearing in commercials and some minor roles, George's first major break was as a commentator with CBS Sports. A 1976 People magazine cover featured a smiling photo of her with the headline, "An ex-Miss America becomes TV's First Lady of the Locker Room."